Hey, what's up, everybody?
Hi, guys. How's it going?
Welcome to Strings Direct. I'm Brandon.
And I'm Sam.
And today we're taking a look at these new Moore preamp pedals. Drive pedals, mini amp simulators.
They are preamps, yeah.
And we are looking at them today.
Yes, so there are 10 available. In front of us, though, we have 5. And I've chosen these as the 5 of the higher gain amps. Gonna call them amps. Let me see if I can name them all. So number one, or they've called number one, and they actually call it Gas Station, is a Diesel Hagen. Number two is a Marshall of some sort. So that's gonna be a 800, 900?
JCM 900.
So 900, yep. Okay. Three is...
I'm not sure how you pronounce this one.
No, I wouldn't get it straight away. Is it a cock?
A cock?
It's a cock.
Is it
Koch? Koch, cock.
Cock. It's a cock power tone.
Let's not get into this. Power tone?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, I got that because on the side of the pedal it says power zone.
So. Okay, that's I see it, yeah. They do got a couple of cheeky little puns on these.
Right, this one's easy because it's got the Van Halen style Frankenstein artwork. Mm-hmm. I think it's called a Frankenstein.
Sure.
It's a 5150. 5150. Called 5153.
EVH 5150.
Sorry, yeah, EVH
5150.
Yeah. And last but... not least,
by any means,
purple one. This is called the Black Knight. So that's an Engel Ritchie Blackmore.
Mm.
And funnily enough, we have one of those right here.
Oh, right, get a shot of that.
Right there. Yeah. There you go. So naturally, it would be rude not to try that up against that. So we will do that. We'll run those later. So what should we start with? How should we go through these? Should I explain how they work first?
Yeah, I think it's best if we kind of have a look at. I mean, basically, these are all the same pedal, essentially, with different circuits for different tones. Mm-hmm. But they all work the same way.
Yeah. So, let's put that on standby. So, I'll take one of these out. Let's take the middle one. So, this is a EVH 5153, they call it.
Sure. This kind of amp is getting more and more popular these days, like as the djent guys come out and they want all that low-tuned, really tight, chuggy kind of ness.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where that tone comes from the 5150.
So how this works, as simple as a standard sort of effects pedal, when you first turn it on, it goes into one channel. It's red here, which I would call the high gain stage of the pedal. Now, if you push the red button, you can get a second channel, or which really I would call channel one. It's like a clean, through to crunch, that kind of thing. At the moment, as they are, if you turn it off, it's completely bypassed. Turn it on, you get either one of those channels.
Whichever channel you've selected previously.
Which one you select.
Sure.
What is cool, but I'm not sure why you'd want that, but what is cool what the pedal does is when the pedal's on, if you hold the button down for a couple of seconds, the light flashes. Now it's on all the time.
Okay.
And if I push the button, it switches between the two channels. So that makes more sense to me.
That is handy. I suppose it depends on if you're using it. If you're using the clean channel of an amp and you want to use it as a drive pedal, you would obviously have bypass and then the sound.
Yeah.
If you're using this pretty much as your amp, then obviously you have two channels, clean and dirty.
Yeah, and I see, so to turn this off, it'll flash again, you turn it off, pedal's off.
Lovely.
Now, I suppose it makes sense to be on or off if you're just using it to go straight into an interface for recording.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because it's off, and then you'll most likely be recording on the one channel at the time. You're not going to be switching channels while you're recording, necessarily, especially for demo and stuff. And that's where that cab sim... it's actually quite handy. Now, what we'll do, we will play a part on each of these.
Sure.
And record the cab sim version straight in, one through the amp. So.
And luckily, we actually have a cab here that I think matches. that's a joke.
Okay, so let's get through and play some. The way we've run these in is as the pedals are a preamp, we want to bypass the preamp in the amp. So guitar goes into the preamp goes out, and it goes into the effects return on the amp. So we're literally getting the power amp stage of the amp, completely bypassing the amps.
Yeah.
True character. I suppose the only character you're getting from the amp is the output tubes that he's using.
Sure. So,
and obviously a different kind of cab you're using, but we won't get into that. Which one are you going to go for first? Let's have a listen through one.
Let's go left to right. So we got here the 003, which is the cock power tone.
Okay.
Right, everything we got. Have a look at the controls on here. Mm-hmm. You got a treble, mid, and bass, 3-band EQ as you would on a lot of amps.
Mm-hmm.
What do you got here? Volume and gain. So, mm-hmm. pretty simple.
With overdrive preamps and this kind of thing, where they usually fall down is with overdrive, with heavy distortion, because they end up very thin, mm-hmm. weedy, no mids. It's kind of, yeah, horrible.
Yeah.
Let's see if these are an exception. So let's start with, go on, whack that on there. So,
right, so
this is literally the guitar going straight into the effects return on the amp. So it's as dry as you get.
Okay. Right, let's see what it can do. Mm-hmm. So as we say, everything 12 o'clock, let's just kick it in and see what...
Roll some bass. Doesn't sound bad at all.
I'm like super impressed by these things. I was not expecting them to sound as good as they do. Mm-hmm. Am I saying that they rival a 2,000 pound amp? Well, it remains to be seen, I guess.
Yeah, okay, spend $2,000 a pedal.
Yeah.
And yeah, so try the other channel on that. So if you just hit the button.
Sure, yeah.
So the back of the gain let you go down on that, so it cleans up.
Still adding a lot to the signal.
Yeah, so it just gives you a bit of tone shape.
Tell me a little bit about how switching between channels, right? So you've got it set up so you're using the two channels on the pedal. You're going from channel, clean channel, to distorted channel.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, there's only one set of knobs.
Yes, but the beauty of this is the pedal does remember how you last set those knobs.
The pedal remembers.
The pedal remember. So if, obviously, the visually... And the
so let's get a clean tone, right?
Yeah,
so
okay.
I'll take this down, I'll dial this down, gain's way off.
Yeah, okay, so I've got the gain right up on the guitar.
It stores the last presets, and then when you go back onto it, your knobs can be everywhere, but it still has the same preset you stored before. But as soon as you touch that knob, it jumps to where it now is, kind of thing.
So where you put the gain right up on the second channel, what's happened then is you go back to the clean channel, and obviously when you move that, well, the knob can't be in two places at once. It's physically impossible. So we'll start from there. But very nice. You can set up your tones, get those set up wherever you are, and then you've got your two channels.
Yeah, exactly.
That's it. Sorted. Let's try the Marshall. Yeah.
Sweet.
So the JCM 900. So I'll let you play around with the thing.
Sure.
So that's just the RDI sound. So let's whack this on.
Clean tone straight into the power amp section.
Okay.
And so there you go.
The drive sound. Yeah.
Yep.
Sounds Marshall-esque, doesn't
Right, so
and what's sound like
maybe
that?
Just so this is full gain.
Full gain.
That wasn't.
At one point have a DSL-100
okay
through that cab and it sounded a lot like that pedal.
Really?
I'm quite impressed.
Yes.
Yeah, so I have to admit I kind of came into this thinking it's a pedal, it's like it's gonna sound like a cruddy version of the original, but so far I'm pretty impressed.
I'm very impressed, in fact. I mean, to be fair, I have no point of reference for the cock, because I've not used one. But it sounds great. As just a drive, it sounds really good. Again, the Marshall, this is kind of blowing me away.
Mm-hmm.
They do sound.
Yeah, I mean, it's great. It's by no means a £1,000 tube amp.
No.
But as £95 is going to get you, that's bloody close.
Yeah, for real. I mean,
anyway, let's stop going on with that. Let's move on. So the next one is the Diesel Hagen.
It's the Diesel.
Okay. So yeah, let's try this.
So again, just for reference, bit of a clean tone.
Yeah. So we're still the same. The same as everything else.
Awesome.
Okay. So whack that in.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. So again, everything down the middle.
Yeah. Something I've noticed with these pedals, as you're moving the knobs, the treble seems to act a bit like a cross between a treble knob and a presence control.
Sure. Okay.
It's because it's got, especially when you can notice it there with that, with this specific one anyway. It sounds a lot like presence, sort of that real sort of fizzy presence you get when you whack up presence on a drive amp, as opposed to just the treble. Really, really like bright. It's due though. It sounds like for that amp, it sounds pretty good.
Cool.
It's not a tone I would go.
Diesel, I mean, what do you reckon? I'd say this one actually sounds... These two were great for high gain. They really pushed it out. That one, I wasn't too impressed with the high gain sound.
No.
But they're...
But when you backed off that gain,
there's
I think
a great
definitely...
kind of crunch sound in there somewhere. Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
There is a sweet spot. Yeah. Again, I don't really have basis for comparison, though. I've not played through.
Sounds good.
Yeah, that's all right, but...
You know the diesel amps are the ones with the... It looks like they're, like, in fans of...
Yeah, no, I have seen them. Yeah. I've definitely seen them. I've just never had the pleasure, shall we say.
Right, next.
Classic right here.
Yeah, okay.
This is I'd imagine this is probably going to be one of their big sellers right now, because there are a lot of guys that want the sound of a 5150.
Yeah, but don't want to pay for one.
They don't want to pay for one, and kindly, Moor has provided you with this little emulator.
The 5053.
Yeah. Snap.
So, let's try this one.
Cool.
Let's see what this is going to sound like.
Right.
So we're looking for heavy, tight, bottomed
heavy, tight
metal distortion.
Definitely.
Right?
Yeah, djent.
I won't go as far as djent. I mean, like, thrash.
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 Yeah.
And, just...
Let's hear it.
Stabbing metal. Quite vowel-y, isn't it?
You hear it traveling through a valve somehow, because I mean it is going through a valve power section.
Oh, I said vowel-y.
Oh, vowel-y.
As in wah pedalesque vowel-y. So. Mm-hmm.
That's a little muddy.
I was actually going to disagree. I was actually going to say let's put a small bottom end in it.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, it's I have to admit, it's not my favourite either.
No.
It feels funny to play. It doesn't feel like an amp to play, whereas the others so far, albeit though the diesel's not a sound that I'd really go for, they've all actually felt a lot like amps to play.
So but in terms of response in that?
Yeah, in terms of response. Whereas this one seems like it's lagging behind a little bit.
Fair enough. Let's see how it cleans up. What if I go full gain and then just clean it up with your gain? We'll be right back.
punk on myself there.
You are a bit, yeah. That's cool. I mean, that just means these pedals can do a lot.
Yeah, it does sound like a 5150, but it doesn't play like a 5150.
No, I mean, that is a thing to be said, that you're always going to realize playing through a tube amp or like a nice big amp, yeah, there is something, you can feel the response in the strings.
You say that, but those are the three so far, before this one.
Sure.
It's going through a cab, it's going through a valve amp power amp section, sure, right? They feel like you're playing through that amp. They do feel like an amp, which is cool. That's really cool. Because, like, as I said, I was skeptical when I first walked in. Now, this is what I expected them to sound to feel like.
Okay, sure.
So, like the 5150. So, that's what I expected.
So, you expected it to get kind of close to the tone, but not necessarily the overall feel of the amp.
And that one's probably hit that on the head.
Okay,
The other three have surpassed my expectations so far. Very impressed. So, anyway, let's move on from that.
Sure.
Let's get to the real test here. So, we have...
AB.
Yeah. We have the real thing, and we have...
We have the real thing.
And not the real thing.
And the fake thing. Cool. Yeah, so this is the...
Do we say it's fake?
Well, I mean, it's real. It's a real Moor. So this is the Black Knight, obviously. This is going for the Ingle Ritchie Blackmore amp. I mean, this thing's a beast. It's 100 watt all tube, something like 4 channels.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah, it's got 4 different gain stages, I suppose. So.
Nice.
Okay, well, let's hit... What do you want to do? Should we hear the pedal first or the amp first?
Let's hear the amp. That's, well... I guess it doesn't really matter.
Okay. Well, seeing as we're sitting here...
Mm-hmm. Let's do the pedal.
Let's do the pedal first.
Cool. Okay. Right, so, again, everything flat. I'll turn the gain all the way up, volume all the way up, and EQ. We're just rocking 12 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's hear that then. Go on in, boy, turn it on. It has a lot more mid than that 51. Put the mid back in. Why turn in the mids down? Do that and that and that and that. Let's see where it's at. That sounds good to me. That sound. I think that's. If the pedal wasn't in front of me, I wouldn't question that it wasn't the sound of the head.
So you.
Giveaway being. Guitar isn't plugged in the front of it.
This is actually Sam's amp, so he knows this amp really well.
Acid test.
Sure. Okay. Let's do it.
Let's plug it in.
Cool. So what we've done now is he's taken He's unplugged the pedal from the effects loop, and he's put the guitar straight through the front end of the amp. So now you're hearing the EQ from the amp itself.
So yeah, if you hadn't guessed already, what I secretly did there when I was changing the pedal sound when I was playing is actually sort of mimicking more or less what the knobs are set on the amp. So volume wise and whatever, it's all gonna be the same. So let's see, shall we?
Yeah.
Okay. Just turn the amp on.
That's a start. Okay, here we go.
What do you think? I can see you thinking something, and I know what I think.
Struggling to find it does sound really good. I mean, the amp may be a little bit tighter.
That's it. That's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
The amp sounds tighter, mm-hmm. ever so slightly brighter.
Yeah.
I think it does sound more real, but
it's negligible. I mean, I'll be honest, it's kind of negligible. I mean, I feel like if you had both of these AB going through the same signal, and you were messing with the tones in that,
you could get them.
You could
pretty much. I'll just play that riff. I'll make sure I'll try and play the thing exactly the same both times.
Okay. Cool. Yeah.
I'll just made it up on the spot, so I might keep changing it. But I'll play that through quick. Play it through the amp. So we're in the amp sound now, to be clear. We're on the amp sound, mm-hmm. right? Okay. So. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, let's really quickly swap these. So, if you would have to be seriously picky to notice if I turned up and put that on top of my amp, or hid that out the back of my amp.
Yep.
And just completely bypass the preamp section of my amp. I don't know why I would necessarily do that. But just for the point of like purpose.
Yeah.
I don't think you'd tell the difference. I don't think you'd say it wasn't the amp. Which is very impressive.
Very impressive. Yeah. I mean, I'll be honest. Like, you can. So we're next to the amp in a clean environment. We can hear every little nuance, every little subtle change, but. You wouldn't hear that, especially live. You definitely mm-hmm. wouldn't hear that. There's mm-hmm. a lot of other stuff going on.
Yeah. And I think we should do now, we'll just reconfigure this, and mm-hmm. we're gonna plug this pedal straight in to the recorder, and we're gonna use the cab sim on it.
Cool. So straight into the pedal.
Yep.
On the high gain setting.
Mm-hmm.
Amp sim is on.
Yeah. Well. Yeah. Okay. Amp mm-hmm. sim's on. Okay. So. This is going to sound weird because we haven't actually got a way of hearing it in here, so I'm literally playing into the recorder and I could just hear my strings in here. Okay, so
cool.
We are now completely blind. We don't know what that sounds like, so we're gonna hear that on the
deaf.
Deaf, sorry.
I'd say deaf, probably. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. We're not gonna know what that sounds like until it comes to the video and gets on YouTube. So
yeah. So we're just as surprised as
you're
you are.
The judge on this one. Let's turn the cab sim off and just see what that sounds like.
Sure.
Okay.
Cool.
So to do that, just hold down the red button. That's it.
Cab sim is off.
Cab sim is off. I'm just imagining that's going to sound terrible. I obviously we don't know yet.
So there it is. Those are the five high gain Moore preamp pedals that have just come out.
Mm-hmm. So I would like to add, from my point of view, I was a lot more impressed than I necessarily may have been. I did think they were just going to sound like amp sims on a computer.
Yeah,
so completely lifeless.
Impressed ain't the word. I mean, I'm impressed. No. I'm impressed about how impressed I am. Yeah. You know,
I'll be honest about for my personal taste here, the 5150 has not cut it for me. That is the only one. But then again, you make your own decision. You've heard it on here. You might think that's the sound. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, for the right thing.
Yeah, I think a lot of people as well, when they're playing through 5150, the sound that you get from a 5150, those kind of guys, they're probably using a lot of gates, a lot of stuff to tighten up even more the sound they got. So it's not going to be just a straight amp sound that you're hearing. I mean, I'd be interested to get it alongside an actual 5150 and have a play, and maybe even in context, if we could, you know.
Mm-hmm. But then again, if it's the sound you're listening for, it's £95.
Yeah.
I mean, all of these sounds for £95.
To be honest,
is mega impressive.
Yeah,
I think
this kind of thing is something you'll keep forever. You can use it in recording context. You can use it live. Mm-hmm. It's not just like an amp sim so much. It's for a lot of things.
And based on your environment as well. Mm-hmm. I don't know what. Obviously, everyone's little room at home is going to be slightly different. This may be the best guitar sound you can get on your computer.
Sure. Very well
for demo purposes. Whatever. Mm-hmm. Might be the best thing you can get.
Nice.
So I am distinctly impressed with that. The Richie Blackmore, the Engel.
I was going to ask.
Impersonation.
I mean, I'll be honest, right? The best thing we can do. Be honest, Sam.
Mm-hmm.
You own the amp. Mm-hmm. You've played the pedal. Is that something that you would pick up to have as a spare or?
I actually will be going. Before I leave today, I'll be taking one home with me.
You are, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice.
Because, and the reason being is that will stay on my desk at home.
Yeah.
And instead of me having to lug all that out of its flight cases and set it up, get the volume right, and then mic it up, make sure it's sounding great there, all I've got to do is go, oh, there's my amp sound. Just plug into that and press record.
Exactly.
That's it. And that will do it for me. I'm not sure if I'd use it live, but I don't need to. I've got one. So, do you know what I mean?
Exactly,
But I am thoroughly impressed with that. Now, it does. Are some of the others going to sound like a £5,000
boutique
amp head?
Very, very legendary amp head.
Guys, it's £95.
Yeah.
I mean, let's end it there because I think that says it. I think they are very, very good for what they are.
Indeed, I would agree with that. Yeah. So on that note,
yeah, make sure you comment below. Let's hear what you think. Say you let us know which one sounded best for you, which one sounded most realistic to you. It'd be very, very nice to hear from you. So
it would, yeah. Like, comment, subscribe, share, all that kind of cool stuff.
Mm-hmm. And for now,
farewell.
Adios.